Hello and welcome to a quick discussion about the Infrared Ion X Professional by JINRI, however you say it. This is a hairdryer that makes some claims, and I want to address some of these claims real quick from a scientific standpoint. It claims it sends ionized air towards your water molecules. Scientifically, will that help water evaporate quicker? Yes, it will. How much of the air passing through this is ionized? Not 100%. There's no such thing as 100% efficiency, right? So we don't know. They don't specify exactly. But whatever ions do go through there will affect water, which is a polarized molecule. It will help separate those and help them evaporate. That's just kind of how it is. The science behind it, is it a big deal? Not really. It's not going to affect it as much as the energy released through the heated air. So, not really an issue with ions. Will it help a little bit? Yes, I expect it will help a certain percentage, probably a small percent. I'm guessing less than 10% without the numbers from JINRI. They haven't published the numbers. So maybe less than 10%. The infrared, oh dear, don't even get me started. There's a lot of myths about far infrared and infrared light. People say that infrared light is why you feel warm in the summer at the same temperature in your room as in winter at the same temperature in your room, is because there's not as much infrared light coming from the sun. That's nonsense. It's just energy. If your floor in the summer, if your floor and walls are hot and you're standing on your floor, you're going to feel warmer than in the winter if your floor is cold, even if the air temperature is the same. Does that make sense? It's just conducting heat versus radiating heat. It's not because the infrared light, it's because all the radiation from the sun and the warmth of the air around you. So, and the, you know, and the floor, everything. So it's just short-sighted people. Okay, can far infrared light help with water evaporation? Yes, it can. Put it on a laser, get some high energy out of that, water will evaporate like crazy. How much does this light they put in here affect water evaporation? Very little, very little. I'm guessing less than 2%, maybe less than 1%, if anything. It's just not enough energy being released from that light to really help with water evaporation. All right, so what are the selling points of this lovely, I might add, hair dryer? Okay, it has the cool button. To me, that's a huge thing, because you don't want to overdry your hair. You don't want to overdry your scalp. Dry scalp is a real problem. That cool button goes a long way, okay? So that cool button is a good selling point. Now we get to the main controls, where all the energy is really released. We have three heat settings, high, medium, low, two fan settings, high, low. And again, you just don't want to overdry your hair or your scalp. Pretty straightforward. So is this worth the money? The answer to that depends on, see, this is first world problems. This is what we address here at Cuddly Kittens, right? First world problems. Are you going to spend the extra money for something like this versus a basic one like the Vidal Sassoon that we compared it to for sound? This one on high is a little bit quieter. We're talking about 2 decibels, which is, you know, pretty insignificant in this range. It's very similar to the Vidal Sassoon, which also has a cool button for sound, for how loud it is. The plug also comes with the very typical GFCI style cutoff right here. Little circuit right here. Reset button, the test button. Hopefully you would never have to use that. So, what do I think of this hairdryer? It's an okay hairdryer. It dries hair. It comes with some interesting attachments that clip on here. I wish they had like a physical connection more than just like the clip, because those things can fall off pretty easily. I would say this is a very middling hairdryer when it comes to overall quality, durability, and a lot of the gimmicky things that they're trying to sell here. The infrared light in particular, it's just an LED that's very unspectacular, not going to release a lot of energy, which is not going to do a lot for drying your hair. Even though infrared sure sounds cool, that's what your remote controls use for a lot of devices. So, you know, it's been around. You don't use your remote control to dry your hair, do you? And people will say, well, it's low output. Exactly, like this, all right? So take it for what it's worth. Interesting device. Hair dryers. Who would have thought they were so interesting? The one thing I'd like to see is I'd like to see a hairdryer with this output. We don't need infrared. Ions, maybe, that's okay. But with this similar output for 5 decibels less, 10 decibels less than what this was running at. So if you have your favorite quiet hairdryer, please leave a comment. Tell us what your favorite quiet hairdryer is. This was sold on Amazon. That's where we purchased it, as a quiet hairdryer. And you can see, very similar to the Vidal Sassoon. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe.